I still think you're up to something.
Would you just want your steak, please?
Idiot.
Dream about it, Frankie. Now, come on, we've got a job to do.
You serious about this?
Of course I'm serious. What's the matter with you?
I just thought that a last minute steak out.
Here. I'm trying that stuff around for you.
Who is this, anyway? You think I'm putting this stuff on you? You're the cats in your belfry. Deserted us. We can do this sort of thing all the time.
Hey.
I hope you like your pasta al dente.
Yeah, I do.
Yep, it'll be ready in a minute.
You don't mean to tell me they tried to prevent you from using your own office?
Well, I wasn't escorted out of the building, perfect for me. But I was conveyed to her in very clear terms that as long as an indictment was pending, my presence was not appreciated.
That's hard to believe.
Well, I don't lose sleep over it, Grant. I haven't. As a matter of fact, Donna Hutchins made me a very interesting offer.
Watch out for her, Dan.
I agree with Grant.
Now, don't you two worry about me. I can handle Donna Hutchins. Oh, Grant. I find the most interesting article in the business section. I mean, I'll show you.
Excuse us.
Well, you know?
Yes?
Your demeanor seems to have changed since Kevin Anderson was here. What did he want to see you about?
Why do you care?
Was it a social visit?
No.
Then it was official business.
Iris, drop it.
Paulina. Kevin is a special prosecutor for the district attorney's office. Don't tell me. Are you in trouble with the law again?
Wow. What did they do? Come up here and turn everything on before we got up here?
Look at this place.
It's very nice of you.
It's incredible.
Our bags are here already. Did you see the bag?
No, there's no. Hey, look, where are the towels at?
It's me.
Oh, wow.
They are very nice.
And bathrobes.
Oh, we're going to have to steal those.
We've got monograms on them. We are not going to steal these.
Yeah,
I bet I know what's back here.
Oh, look at this. Oh, my favorite food. This is incredible.
I knew it.
Organic peanut butter.
There is a jacuzzi out there on the deck.
Oh, well, kinds of songs out there. Look at it. There's a jacuzzi out there.
Yes.
Oh, and they can't use it. It's so cool. It is. Your favorite kind of chocolate, the 2 pound size.
Yeah, we are using that jacuzzi.
How do you feel? It's 10 degrees below outside. It's going to be freezing.
Well, that's the point. We're going to run out there barefoot in the snow, and then we're just going to jump in the jacuzzi, which is sad.
Then what?
What do you think?
Oh, you're having a good time, aren't you, young lady?
Why are you so serious?
Why am I so serious?
Yeah.
I have a surprise for you.
You do? Yeah.
Yeah. This is very important. Yeah. And I hope that you're ready for it.
Thank you.
What?
Yes? I get it.
Right.
Have you run up? Hello? Goodbye.
I don't know. Somebody hung up. Okay, so, what were we talking about now?
I don't know. You said that you have a surprise for me?
Right, yes.
No, Dean, I gotta tell you, I don't know how much more I can tell you. I mean, a trip to Colorado, a limo waiting in the runway, this place.
Nice.
Yeah, I'm just glad that the record company's picking up the tab.
You're glad.
Yep.
Yeah. Let's go do that jacuzzi thing you were talking about. Come on.
What?
Yeah, let's go do it.
I know, but I suddenly think
the description that you were giving me of running naked through the snow sounds very lovely. Yes,
no.
I like it, running.
What? You are not going to tell me that you have a surprise for me and not do anything about it.
Oh, I'm not?
No, you are not.
Oh, why not?
Because that's teasing and I hate it.
You hate it if I do that?
Yes, I do.
Okay, all right, you talked me into it. Come over here. You sit yourself down right there. Okay?
You sure?
Sit right there on top.
Where are you going?
I'm just
going
to get the surprise. Over here.
Yeah, what is it? What did you do?
Okay.
Oh, I get it. I'm supposed to pick the right one, right?
Well,
I'll pick this one.
But no.
What if it's the wrong one?
I already picked it.
I already picked it, so I'll open it.
Okay.
You don't want me. I love surprises.
So now you're business owners.
We'll see about that.
Everything all right, you ladies?
Oh, it's just perfect.
Perhaps you should sheathe your claws, Iris, at least until the main course is served.
This is going to be quite an interesting little dinner.
Could you find anything out?
No, not really, but I do know that Kevin didn't happen to ask if the policeman was born.
Do you think he's in legal trouble?
Yes, I do. The question is, will she tell Grant about it before his reputation suffers again?
Do you have something to tell me?
No, you need the time, Grant.
Then I'll listen.
There's nothing you can do.
You're not going to start keeping things from me again, are you? I thought we were beyond that.
I love you.
If you're in trouble,
excuse me, Senator. You have a phone call, sir.
Who is it? Would you take a message, please?
I'm afraid I tried, sir, but the lady said it was urgent.
Who is it?
Miss Victoria Hudson.
I guess I picked the right box.
Do you like it?
Did you pick it out yourself?
Yeah.
Did you pay for it yourself?
Well, that's a very romantic question.
Dean, I'm sorry. I don't want to be weird, but this is too much.
Why?
I can't accept this.
Why not?
Because you spent too much money. That's
why. Could you stop talking about money? Please. Please.
How am I supposed to keep up with you?
How
am I supposed to stay interesting to you when you have all of this?
Interesting? You want to stay interesting?
I'm
going to
cry.
Don't you dare go crying. Okay? Listen to me. Please. You're the most important thing in the world to me. All the rest of this stuff is just icing. It's icing on the cake.
Dude, I don't doubt anything.
But then why do you keep talking about money and stuff?
You may not feel the way you feel about me now forever.
Not to me, it doesn't. Not to me.
But our lives are on such different paths.
Paths cross.
And sometimes...
Listen to me, I cannot do this alone. You're my rock. You're the reason that I want to wake up in the morning. And you are the most important thing in the whole world, and I love you more than anything in this world. And if it doesn't involve you, I'm not interested.
I so much.
I could never ever leave you behind.
Maybe we could slice it.
But that never happens to Angela.
Well, Angela is perfect. Everybody knows that. Besides, have you ever watched Angela do it?
Well, of course I haven't watched her. I guess I overestimated my abilities.
Well, that happens.
It was all so simple, and I thought I would be fine.
Donnie, you are fine. Everything is just fine. I guess we can renovate the kitchen. Can we order some takeout food now?
Yes. I think you better dial. I'm afraid I might break my fingernail. Yeah, I'm supposed to stand around and these things, right?
No sign of him yet. What, didn't I get you everything you need?
You want me to draw something on his breast to do that? Why? Is that obvious?
Yes. Mr. Burke, Frankie, Mr. Burke. How many times has a guy had to tell you something before it sinks in?
Now wait 1 minute, you bucko. You drag me kicking and screaming off on some stakeout with no warning, no prep time, and no explanation to some abandoned warehouse with nothing better to do than to dress up. And then you have the nerve to
act as if those clothes on and I have to do it myself, right? I've got to catch Burke in for granted to let them.
No
buts. I found out that this guy has a predilection for fishnet stockings, and don't mind his thing on what I mean.
Well, thank you for finally telling me. And you are a bigger decoy in my mind.
Close on and get out there and start your stuff from back. And go home now if there's a remuneration for your trouble.
Why is it that you always put me into situations where I have to wear sleazy clothing in order to work?
I really want to trust private investigations that can be off what I wear suits when it's become a lawyer.
This is it. This is what this is all about.
What can I hear?
Yeah.
You actually thought I wanted to get you alone in a rabbit fest in Saudi warehouse?
Yeah. Rabbit fest is
Frankie. I know that you don't trust that, but I'm trying to respect your feelings. So, I want you in my life as my friend and my business partner, and all that other stuff. It's over.
Over?
Well, get some more money, don't you think?
Now, you know how to use this, so why don't you put it on and we'll run a test, and that way I'll be able to hear whatever Dirk says to you. Everything okay?
Sure.
Can I talk to you or something?
Jack?
You seem a little disappointed that I've decided not to let my feelings for you get in the way anymore.
I'm not disappointed, guys. I'm so surprised.
Yeah. Well, see, I had this long talk with Felicia, and she was really able to help me out.
Yeah. What did she say?
Oh, she thought we'd get along much better if we were just friends.
Felicia said that?
Yeah. Good idea, huh? Listen, I'm going to go scope the docks one more time. Why don't you do your drag, okay, partner?
To say that that young man, Kevin Anderson, wasn't hellbent on seeing the angel, and if he wasn't Iris's ex.
Oh, darling, he's hardly that.
Well, I might actually like him. How do you know him, Paulina?
We met a couple of times.
Yes, he must have had something very important to tell you for him to have tracked it down here tonight.
Funny, I asked exactly the same thing, detail.
I'm sorry, Michael.
What does that wonderful assistant of yours have to say tonight?
Well, we're working on a human interest story with a local reporter Vicky wanted to read me the copy before we had it approved for publication.
Don't tell me she managed to get story approval.
She's something, isn't she?
Oh, she's the best thing to have happened to both my sons. A professional for you, of course, Dan.
Of course. I only hope that Ryan allows her to live her own life once they're married.
Ryan appreciates everything that Victoria has to offer.
I hope so, because she won't settle for less, I assure you. Paulina and I were just discussing something before the phone call. Would you excuse us? Okay, what is it?
Kevin came by to warn me about something.
Involving you?
Marley Hudson is pressing the DA's office to reopen the case.
Dick's shooting?
Yeah. Nice, huh?
What prompted this?
I don't know, girl. Hey, maybe you could ask your old pal Vicky what her sister's intentions are. She'll probably know.
You told me the police determined the whole thing was an accident.
Yes, they did. But Kevin said something about, I don't know, civil charges or something.
Wait a minute. Marley's bringing a civil suit against you on
what
grounds?
I don't know, Grant. All I know is she's out to get me, damn it.
I wonder if I know what this means.
How can you do that?
I have ways of getting information.
But, Grant, you can't get involved now.
I'm with you, aren't I? That makes me involved.
Grant, I kept quiet about this for months, so you would be protected.
I will not hide anymore. I'm going to be with you. I'm going to protect you, don't you know? Yes, Dad.
Dinner.
Good. We'll be right there. We'll talk more about this when we get back to the suite, okay? You okay?
Thank you.
My dining room isn't fit for occupancy, so I hope no one minds having dinner in here.
Oh,
this does look wonderful, doesn't it? I hope everyone likes their meat rare.
I have something to say.
You don't have to.
Yes, I do. Kevin came behind you telling me that Marley Hudson is pressing the state to reopen the case of Jake's shooting last year.
I see. I suppose you wanted you to know since you were married to Jake.
No, Spencer, he wanted me to know because I was the one who pulled the trigger. Well, there's so much grass in this place.
Yeah. It's probably really pretty in the daytime, too, you know? All the light.
Yeah. You don't think anyone can see us, do you?
I know.
Okay.
Except maybe that guy over there.
Where? Do you
stop that!
Now you're gonna make me paranoid for most of the night.
Uh-oh.
You sure.
We're at the top of our very, very own mountain, I hope you know.
Yes.
That's right, and the people at the front desk told me that nobody can get into this cabin or has access to this cabin, except, of course, the staff of the place. And the staff is not coming up here unless we ask them to, right? Thanks. Well, I feel okay.
You know what?
What?
I forgot about these.
What?
Presents.
You forgot about those?
I didn't forget about those.
You sure did?
Nope. These are those.
Oh, Dean, wait a minute.
What?
Don't tell me you did something crazy like purchase three pieces of expensive jewelry.
Oh, I don't know. Maybe I do.
Oh, Dean, you're crazy.
Why? Why?
Fine. I'm not going to sit here and tell you not to spend your money to show you how much you care about it. Oh. All right?
Good, I'm done.
Dean?
See, I figured... This is can wear to school, right?
Yeah, of course.
You know that, Lisa. So I couldn't think, I couldn't think. Should I get the fancy bracelet, the funky bracelet? Do I get the fancy necklace? So
you decided to get them both, right?
Well,
I'm afraid to ask what's in the third box.
I don't do because it's my very favorite.
Yeah.
My very favorite. I know you're this
game. Okay.
It's my favorite one.
And I shouldn't have done this.
Supposed to be real antiques.
Antiques?
Real antiques, what's that? That's me, real antiques.
Oh, yeah. What is it? These are gorgeous.
You like
them?
Yeah. Yeah, they really are my favorite. So they're very pretty. See what they look like. Yep. Those are nice.
I can't believe you did this.
There you go. Take them. Take all of this and keep it, okay?
You shouldn't have done this.
Why not? I might be a little crazy, but I think you're worth it.
All right, I'll accept these on one condition, all right?
Uh-uh.
You promise me, the next paycheck you get, you're going to spend it on yourself, you hear me? Or better yet, you're going to put it in the bank, and you're going to let it sit, okay?
I'll do something useful and constructive for my next paycheck.
Good.
Yeah. I'll have to spend it on you.
Dean!
I have to. Remember what we talked about in the little cottage last week?
Yeah,
when I got a little money, a little extra money, and some time, that we were going to hire somebody to find your old man, remember? Well, that's what we're going to do with my next royalty check. No arguments about it. No ifs, ands, or buts. I love you.
I love you, too. Dean, there's somebody walking around outside.
What?
I just saw somebody walk by the window.
Are you going to the glass?
You think I'm dating John?
I think you're playing house with John. And if the circumstances were just a little different than they are, who's to say what would be going on by now?
How dare you deny it? I am not interested in John. He was married to
Sharon. Only you that what's going on between you and John is something that neither one of you is capable of admitting or recognizing at this stage of the game, did it?
You really have a school in Central.
And you are totally into denial.
Denial.
Wake up and smell the coffin. Mary Frances Fine, this is your life.
When was the last time you tried to hand
it to him? Don't ask. You don't want to know.
No, I don't, Rose.
Did Gregory take his bottle?
Oh, about half.
He sleep?
Mm-hmm. That doesn't mean anything. He sleep for now, but he hasn't slept a whole night through in quite a while.
If he cries again, can I go up?
Sure.
So, away from your brother?
Spoke to him yesterday, actually. He called.
That's nice.
I guess he hasn't called you yet, huh?
No.
Well, I'm sure he will.
No, I'm sure he won't. He won't call me unless he needs to know something about the girls.
Hmm. He said that, had a nice talk with you before he left.
Yeah, it was nice. It was confusing, but what do you expect from the two of us?
I said he's having a great time.
Well, I'm glad that he's on his own. You know, I think it would have been disastrous if he'd taken Rachel.
Why?
Because he hasn't been on his own in a long time, and I think he needs to find himself again.
Well, he's doing that.
No. Between you and me, he kissed me goodbye.
Kissed? No, I wouldn't read too much into that, though.
I'm not. It just made me think. It made me feel a lot of things. It made me feel a lot of regret.
Mm. I understand that.
We didn't do anything but fight these last few months. And I know that it's been over for a long time, but it's just been nice to have him close. You know, it just makes me feel safe.
You can always call me.
I just hope the girls don't fall apart at the seams while he's gone.
Well, I think that Vicky and Marley are pretty grown up.
Oh, Marley. Marley doesn't know what she wants. She's all over the place. And Victoria, I worry about her, John. She's so much like I am. Look at all the mistakes that I've made.
Donna, you're still in one piece, aren't you?
She's working very closely with Grant Harrison.
Oh, is that a bad thing?
I think it could be potentially catastrophic.
Why?
Because he's a very powerful man, and he's just the opposite of his brother. Just like your mother. If you were me, look what happened to us.
Well, we were just kids.
Victoria is not exactly the society matron.
Well, she loves Ryan, doesn't she?
Do you trust Grant Harrison?
Well, not as far as I can throw him, but I have different reasons.
Well, then your reasons are some of the same reasons that make me nervous.
Let me get this straight. You think that Vicky is attracted to Grant?
I think that she's drawn to him in spite of herself, just the way you and I were drawn to each other all those years ago.
Are you sure?
We knew what we were doing was wrong. We did it anyway. What if that happens to Victoria?
I made her stand trial for something that I did. She hasn't forgiven.
very supportive.
It does look delicious.
Miss Alistair, listen.
And Miss Hudson, my girlfriend. It's perfect.
She should have worn shoes.
Yeah, sure. Here. Listen. You've given me things before that have meant more than anything in the world to me. Right? Like the song for Jenna. Like your love. And your smile. I don't need you to give me expensive things, Dean. I just need you. That's all. You get the point?
Yeah, I think so. Oh, no!
What?
Oh, I was supposed to have a conference call with Ace Records right now.
Why don't you call? Yeah.
It's business, okay? Do you think that maybe two hours or something, maybe I just got to get a space force or something? Vicky sent the proofs of the bribe and I'll be in touch
with you. You're doing an interview with Iris?
Iris is helping me with a pet project.
What kind of pet project?
As a matter of fact, I have done a big chunk of downloading. I'm not sure there should be a couple of boxes there for us to show you. Excuse me, sir.
What have you gotten Bradley involved in?
I haven't got him involved in anything. He came to me
with what?
With something you wouldn't understand.
But Vicky's
well, of course, she's his trust alone. And from the way that you looked at Grant every time she called him, I would say that she's a little bit more than that. Wouldn't you?
Are you and Spencer serious?
What?
With each other?
Yes, yeah.
Also, possibly I could be related to you through the Harrison family as well, right? Good grief.
You honestly think that you would be included in this family?
What, you're going to try and keep me out of this one too, Iris?
I don't think I'll have to. I think Vicky Hudson is going to do that all by herself.
I'm sorry that I rattled on about my personal agenda.
That's quite all right.
Mm-hmm.
soon.
Ryan? Jane Hudson. Is Frankie there? She's what? Where? Right. I'm gonna stay here because we just need about an hour. Frankie is on a soak up someplace down at the back. Unless he's in trouble. Shadows in case I'm
looking. Oh, of all the half-baked, bossy, shoddy, most ridiculous sketches. Those women from Rapist? Oh my God, Dad, that's my picture. What is this?
I told you I was going to take care of Drake McKinnon. This will bury him for good.
How can you do this to me?
I'm not doing anything to you. This doesn't have anything to do with you.
How can you say that? Brad, this is going to destroy him. But he came through for me. Brad, please, I never asked you to go after him. I told you to let it go.
You still care about him? Everything he did to you?
Brad, the man gave me my freedom.
He melted me.
What?
You did make love to him, little man, didn't you?
This is so lovely, Spencer. Aren't you glad you're with me instead of Donna Hudson?
You knew about my business dinner with Donna.
Well, you might have thought it was a business dinner, but Donna Hudson didn't.
You made me change my plans tonight, so I wouldn't have dinner with Donna.
Come on, darling. Is it a crime to want to be with you?
You can drop the kidnap promise.
What do you mean?
That may have worked with your daddy, but it does nothing for me. I don't play games. If you don't know that by now, you can leave. For good.
I got someone. Where's the girl? Let's do a little financial planning. Come on, they'll pay hard to get. It'll be worth it, I promise. You sure? Meet us at that. And have fun. 30 minutes tops.
Son of a... Great, just great. Hey,
I'm not about to lose you, too.
Hogging all the blankets.